Hey there, I'm Jake. I am a guitar tutor from Birmingham Rock School. Today's Tutor Chip Tuesday video is going to be on the song Crazy Train, and more importantly, the three main sections of the song: the intro, the verse, and the chorus. So as digital jam songs go, this one is quite a tricky one. So only approach the more difficult riffs if you are intermediate slash beginner. The difficulty in this song is about how fast it is and all the little kind of widdly bits that go in between it. So I'm gonna break it down into three sections: the intro, the verse, and the chorus. This is the intro riff. Rhodes, the guitarist of this song, is an incredible guitarist, one of my biggest inspirations on guitar, and this riff is just iconic from the start. You hear the bass and the drums come in, you hear the Ozzy Osbourne sing his vocals, and then that just into that is just absolutely amazing. So how do you play it? This is how you play it. It's all based around this F sharp minor scale. Well, F sharp Aeolian, basically. And then the next part of the riff is rolling around on the B, which is the fourth of F sharp. We're rolling from this F sharp, and we're just going to play the first four notes, which go like this. Second fret on the E string, twice. Fourth fret on the A string, once, back down to the second fret. And you, as you notice, it's just a power chord. So it's just playing the power chord going like this. The next group of the riff goes like this, which is fifth fret to the second fret, which is the F sharp, and then the fourth fret, which you've already played, back down. So if you break it into groups of four, the first one goes, and then the next one, when you put them together. Pause the video, have a quick go at that, and then I will count you in and we will play that together. One, two, three, four. Well done. If you're struggling with it, go back, practice it a little bit more, and then come back to this video. The next group of four is we shift the position now from our first finger, is jumping to the second fret of the A string, and that note is B. This one's a bit tricky because you're kind of pedaling off your little finger here. But with a bit of practice, and practice a bit, the better and faster you'll get at this riff. So, the first group of four goes, which is second fret on the A string, and then on the E string, you're going 5-4-5. Just like that. And then the next group of four kind of plays the same thing, but instead of going back up to the five for the last note, you're just gonna end on zero. So you're gonna go. And now it's time to put them together. So you're going for the first one, then you're going. Every single note here is an eighth note. One, two. The next riff is the verse. Going into the verse, you play this amazing, which is just a D major chord to an E major. It's just playing three chords. It's just A major, E major, and D major. So you can get away with playing the riff like this. But this riff is played in different inversions. The A major is played like this, which is on the D string, 7th fret, on the G string, 6th fret, on the B string, 5th fret. That's your A major triad. The next one, the E major, is you slide it all the way down a semitone, but then you switch your second finger and your first finger. So your third finger stays on the D string, but your first finger is now jumping to the fourth fret of G, and your second finger is jumping to the fifth fret of B. Quite a tricky change, but as long as you hold down your third finger and slide down that semitone, quite an easy thing to go over. Then you move that down a tone, which is a D major chord, and then you can end on an A major down here. So it's like a lower sound to this. They sound the same, but they're different inversions. Again, refer back to another Tutor Tip Tuesday video where I went over chords. The riff pedals off the open A. Just like that. To make it easier for yourself, you can just play. All that is just going A, 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 A. A, 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 and then hold on to the A until it comes back round. I will play the riff to a slower speed and then I'll play it to a faster speed. One, two, one, two, three, four. I'll play it to speed. So now the chorus. This bit is probably the hardest part of the song, so bear with me on this one. Around again F sharp, and you want to play just like that, which is F sharp E. You can play just like a lone E. So you would go, then you would play a D chord. So I like to play the D power chord. You can go, the inversion doesn't matter. So you go F sharp D. Then you do the same thing. Then it leads in to the chorusy bit where he's going off the rails on the crazy train. So the bit that's the... That bit, you can just play with F sharp D. Twice. So, one, two, three, four. It's the chorus, which goes A, E, and then F sharp. Chorus, the... You can just play F sharp over the... Over that little solo bit, just play the chord F sharp. So it's A major, E major, F sharp. But then, after those bits where you've played it twice, A, E, F sharp, A, E, F sharp, you are going to play this riff. That riff is quite tricky because of the rhythm of the note, so I will talk you through it. So it follows the F sharp, E, F sharp riff that we've already done in the first bit, which goes... But then the riff now goes 2 on the E string, only on the E string, 2, 4, 5, 4, 2 open, 2, 4. In that order, going 1, 2. So you got this. Then you play it again. But with a D and then an E after it. You can play out. Slowly, this riff goes. Thank you. And those are the three main riffs to the song Crazy Train. So hopefully this video makes learning the Digital Jam song much, much more easier to play. It is a tricky song, so if you do want to have a look at the tab online, I definitely recommend that. Most of the tab is correct anyway, because it's a pretty old song. Sometimes you might find chords that are a little bit wrong, but, you know, that's okay. As long as you're following the main guide of this song. So yeah, that was Crazy Train explained. I hope you're all okay, and I will see you in the classroom. See you later, guys.